好，各位同事，我哋咧就。
Good afternoon, members. This is a subcommittee on proposed resolutions under the District Court Ordinance and the Small Claims Tribunal Ordinance. This is the first meeting. It's the appointed time. We have a quorum. I call the meeting to order. First, election of chairman. Nominations, please. I nominate Mr. Holden Chow. Any seconders? Seconded by Mr. Wong Ting Kwong. Mr. Chow, do you accept? I do. Any other nominations? I count to three. One, two, three. Mr. Ho, please come up to chair the meeting. Thank you, members. I'll ask anyway, do we need a deputy chairman? If you don't think so, then we will start. We'll ask the administration to come in and join us. Whilst the administration is coming in to join us, I will talk about declaration of interest. Under Rule 83A of the Rules of Procedure, members may not move any motions or amendments on matters with direct or indirect pecuniary interests unless a declaration of the nature of the interest is declared. We have the administration here with us. Perhaps I'll ask the administration to first explain the two resolutions before I open the floor for members to ask questions. In 2015 and 2016, the Judiciary conducted a review of the civil jurisdictional limits of the District Court and the Small Claims Tribunal. We have analyzed the caseload of District Court and Small Claims Tribunal, economic indicators, as well as the views of the stakeholders. We now propose resolutions under the District Court Ordinance and the Small Claims Tribunal Ordinance to adjust the civil jurisdictional limits. You'll find details in paragraph 2 of the paper. We aim to enhance the distribution of cases amongst courts of first instance, the District Court and the Small Claims Tribunal, and enhance access to justice for the public. At the same time, we aim to lower litigation costs. We have previously consulted the Law Society, the Bar Association. We have also obtained general support from the AJLS panel of the LegCo. I ask members to support these two resolutions. We're happy to answer questions. Thank you. I now open the floor for members to ask questions. Perhaps we will have 5 minutes each for each members, question and answers included. We have Mr. Dennis Kwok. Thank you. In general, the legal sector supports this proposed amendments very strongly. As you know, that for CFI, the Court of First Instance, there is a backlog. When the limit is increased from 1 million to 3 million, it will be appropriate. I have two questions. First, for DC district courts, will you recruit more judges with experience of civil litigation? Because when the limit is raised to 3 million, I believe the caseload will increase. Secondly, well, for the financial limit of small claims is increased from 50,000 to 75,000. It is very small and rather meaningless. I'll defer to my colleague, Mrs. Ho. In relation to manpower resources, we propose to increase 4 district court judges and 3 deputy registrar of the district court. We think that a lot of work can be taken up by the deputy registrar. We have got support from the AJLS panel. In the coming few months, we will start recruitment. How many posts will be created? 4 DC judges. New one. New creation of posts. Yes. They will all be responsible for civil matters. Well, they are additional posts pursuant to this proposal, and there will be another 3 deputy registrars. In the level of small claims tribunal, we have done some assessments. We think that at this stage, we need to consider additional case law resulting from our proposal on small claims tribunal. We will keep in view the situation and regularly review the situation to see if we need to increase manpower. 75,000 is not very meaningful. I really think that you need to increase it by a substantial extent, say for example under $100,000. For these cases, there is no need to retain lawyers. We have conducted assessment. We think that the proposed increase to $75,000 is appropriate. We have heard from different members whether this should be increased to $100,000. We will actively keep in view case law to see if there is any need to increase it further in the future. I have no further questions. Next, Mr. James Toh. I would like to follow up on Mr. Dennis Kwok's questions. I'd like to look at it from an objective and scientific way. Say, from 50,000 to 75,000. Well, how many years ago was it last raised? I remember I was part of it when there was a proposal to increase it to 50,000. The last time was 1999. Well, now we're in 2018. It's over a decade ago. Of course, you don't follow everything. You don't follow inflation with everything, for everything. But using inflation is an objective indicator when it comes to, say, contract values or conveyancing. I don't know if you have used any formula that it should be 75,000 instead of say 78,000. What about cases with a value of 100,000 $100. People won't get a lawyer to go to take the case to court because costs may be higher than the amount claimed. You want to enhance access to justice. Perhaps you need to allow these cases to be heard in Small Claims Tribunal. Perhaps you have done some internal consultation. Well, I don't know whether you will think like this, that now that members all of a sudden propose $100,000, you will have to start from scratch. But let me give you an example. I don't know whether this will happen. Perhaps I or another colleague proposes $100,000. Would you say, oh no, I would rather withdraw the resolution? It's just like the Labour Advisory Board. You would rather withdraw everything than have it raised to more than 75,000. We feel very strongly about $100,000, and if you refuse to increase it to $100,000, and we would like to make the proposal, would you simply withdraw it? We have been hearing different views from members, including a suggestion of raising it to 100,000. Apart from inflation, we have taken into account case load. If we increase it by a large extent, it will have a huge impact on case load, and as a result, there may be a backlog. You mean that between 75,000 and 100,000, there will be a lot of, there will be a huge increase in case load, and you won't be able to recruit enough judicial officers. But it is an assessment, it can't be 100% correct. But you can use historical data of cases between 75,000 and 100,000 at the small, in the district court. To be honest, I don't really believe that there are many cases at the district court with a claim value between 75,000 and 100,000. Well, in a small claims tribunal, there is no legal representation, so the claim amount will be lower. We don't have a very scientific method to decide on the figure.
Well, 75,000 to 100,000 in the last 5-10 years. How many of these claims were brought up in the district court? I don't think there were a lot. If you could say there were 234 cases in the last 5 years, then the increase of 200 plus in the small claims tribunal, I don't think it would overload the small claims tribunal. Well, our forecasted increase, there would be more than 1,000 cases increase per year, so there might have there might be some actual impact on the workload. So we need to strike a balance. We have to and I know ask you. You can ask. You can respond now or in writing later. If I haven't decided yet, but if I let's say have the urge to increase the limit to 100,000, would you withdraw the resolution? Honestly speaking, we have the stakeholders' consultation. They want us to implement this as soon as possible. So we have not considered this. I just want to ask you, will you withdraw it? At this point, I cannot answer you. Well, we will answer, but since we have expectations, well, I also want you to, my first request, including Mr. Kwok Wing Hung, maybe others as well, but I can't speak on their behalf. Mr. Kwok Wing Hung and myself seem to want to ask for a 100,000 limit. So I would like you to respond later. Will you increase it to 100,000? And if I seek to increase it to 100,000, would you withdraw the resolution? I have a second round as well. Second round, the transitional arrangements. Let's say, I'm not sure if the ordinance deals with it. Your proposed limit is 75,000, but let's say in the district court we have a 60,000 case being tried. Well, I believe the number of these cases will be very small, but I won't rule them out. If as long as they don't exceed the limitation period, then it's fine. But we already have cases that are being tried. Is there a mechanism or a principle where you don't have a method to deal with it? $50,000 to $75,000 cases, can they be deferred to the Small Claims Tribunal? Or I would feel that if they wanted to be handled by Small Claims, they would have chosen that in the first place. But if the other party has legal representation, they might want to change back to the Small Claims Tribunal. But before they have done so, they might have already spent some legal fees. So is it possible for the district courts to wait and for the judge to transfer the case to the Small Claims Tribunal if he feels it's equitable? Do we have that mechanism? If we don't, why not? And if so, how will you strike a balance? I note that the legal advisor has a similar question, so let's see how you respond. Thank you, Chairman. We had responded to the legal advisor. We had written a letter, and we have also answered, and as Mr. James Toh said, the district courts will continue to have a power to rule-related cases, but the situation is if both parties, they wish to revert to SCT to try the case, the applicant can withdraw, they can consider to withdraw after seeking legal advice. And as Mr. James so said, they might have already incurred some costs. There is a option for them to do so. So they withdraw from the district court and start again at the SCT. So it's not considered having two goes at the cherry. So how legal costs will be ruled, that's a separate issue. Could we have cases reverted to SCT? And there's no arrangement. So Mr. James O says that you have to withdraw and then start again at a CT. But in the transition, could you consider that arrangement? Mr. Cho is thinking the High Court and District Court, they have such a ordinance to deal with that mechanism. At the District Court and SCT, there isn't. That's because one consideration might be, as you mentioned, the legal costs. Because at the DC, you can have legal representation, there are legal costs. In SCT, they cannot seek legal counsel. Well, you can rule the legal costs and then revert to SCT, but that would be a complex arrangement to ensure that it's fair to both parties. You can allow the courts to deal with the costs. They have always done so. Well, I also have, it's in my first round, I just want to follow up because I have a separate meeting. I'm not sure. I do have another engagement. I hope that, could you, after your question, could you end earlier so that they can respond in writing? I also wish to change the jurisdiction limit. These are some basic questions and there are some technical issues that we need to resolve, and I'd like you to respond in writing. I'm open to reason. If you think that it shouldn't be reverted to SCT for the reasons that you gave, such as the reasonableness of legal costs, or they might have reminded the parties, if they revert to SCT, you might lose costs, or even if they lose, they want to cap their losses, they don't want to raise the stakes. Some people might wish to cap their losses and seek subsequent claims. So could you give us the reasons why it's not possible? And if I make such an amendment, would you withdraw this resolution? So I hope that you can answer them in one go. And on the next occasion, I will tell you, given your response, what I will decide. So I would hope that Chairman have another meeting for these details. Well, I think the government needs to take note of Mr. To's requests. He has asked for a written response. Next, I have a question. Of course, the government has responded to some questions. In the past, I have always championed for the limit being raised from 50,000 to 100,000. In fact, a lot of our colleagues have the same thinking, and I was also one of the early proponents to increase the limit from 50,000 to 100,000, and you understand that the background. A lot of times people are worried about costs. They would rather get a haircut. They would forfeit some of their claims, make a smaller claim, and go to SCT. Well, we don't want to see this inequitable situation. That's why we ask for an increase in the limit. So I want to be a bit more practical and ask, SCT, I want to understand, if we increase it from 50,000 to 75,000, could you explain the relevant increase in staff expenses, including judges, because since the government responded, we have received a lot of public inquiries, and For example, wait queuing time lengthen because there are more cases, and if the increase goes from 50,000 to 75,000, what is the estimated case workload increase? I know you answered. Could you respond again? I'd just like to hear your assessment. Thank you. Thank you, Chairman. In the SCT, we, after adjusting the jurisdiction, we need to add two SCT judges, adjudicators, and together with the SCT relocating to West Kowloon Magistracy, the workflow will be fine-tuned. There is a arrangement, so the workflow, the case workflow, would have improved. And when both are implemented, we are confident that the two adjudicators, the two extra adjudicators, can handle the increased workload. Our initial assessment is that the case workload will roughly 49,600 per year will go to 51,600. 49,600. It will increase to 51,000, roughly. So every year, you're adding 1,000, 2,000 cases because of this adjustment. Okay. Okay, thank you. But the actual trial cases, the increase will be larger. We estimate 1,490 would go up to 1,700. So a 200 plus case increase. So that is the actual trial cases made after the application. Well, I want to ask, we have two extra adjudicators, but according to our understanding of SCT, well, if you go above the DC, there are legal representatives. I need to declare I'm also a practicing lawyer. So the client legal viewpoints have already been handled and would be submitted to the judges. But in SCT, you understand, the adjudicator needs to do the legal viewpoint work for both parties, and nobody will help them. They have to do it themselves. So in the past, there have been some views that there are no lawyers to handle that work. So the adjudicator is working quite hard. So in staff support, in this increase, so aside from adjudicators, I'm saying in the SCT, will you employ other support staff? Some support staff will handle explanations, or after receiving the case, they will, according to legal arguments, relieve some of the burden, so that can relieve some of the adjudicator's workload.
Is there any chance that there will be such arrangement? Yes, mainly in two areas. In small claims tribunals, after it's been relocated to the West Kowloon law courts, there is an information established for Small Claims Tribunal. The center will provide support to prospective claimants by providing information to them. Sorry, there needs to be a voting done in the Establishment Subcommittee. We have to pause the meeting for now.